This next video will show you how to complete the first quadrant in the California State University application. To begin, please select the first quadrant, also known as personal information. When you click on the quadrant, it's going to show you each section within the quadrant and your progress through each question. We can see that I've already completed each section because they're checkmarked. Let's go ahead and start with the first section, which is release statement. As you go through the questions, please be sure to checkmark each box. So the first one is regarding certification, second is regarding release of contact information, and the third is regarding additional information release. After you click on continue to next section, you'll be given the option to either go back to the dashboard, which will take you to the first page where you see all four quadrants, or you can go to continue to next section. I'm going to click on continue to next section. This next section is asking about biographic information. The first question is asking about your name. This section is pre-populated based on the way that you answered your name in the profile section. If you need to make changes to your name, please select profile section. The next question is asking about alternate name. If you have any materials under a different name, such as transcripts, please select yes. The next question is asking if you have a name that's different from your legal name. The next question is asking about legal sex. Please select the appropriate option to your legal sex. There will be additional questions regarding sexual orientation, gender identity, and gender expression. Your responses are for informational purposes only. No information provided will be used in a discriminatory manner or affect your application for admission. The CSU collects this voluntary demographic information to provide services to all student populations. Please keep in mind that your responses are kept private and secure. The next question will ask about birth information. Please click on the calendar to select your date of birth. It will also ask for country, city, state, and county. And the last section will ask additional questions about applicant information. Please be sure that you go through each question and read them carefully. Once you're finished, please select Save and Continue. The third section is asking about contact information. So the first is your current address. Second and third are regarding your phone number and your email. Please be sure that your email is current and that it's an email that you frequently check, as this will be the email that the universities will be contacting you through. This section is asking for citizenship and residency information. Under U.S. citizenship, please select the option that is most applicable to you. If you are an AB 540 student, please select none. If you were born outside of the U.S., what year did you or will you move to the U.S.? Under residency, it is asking what U.S. state or possession do you regard as your permanent home? If you regard California as your permanent home, you can select California. If you reside in another country, you can select reside in another country. The next question will ask, do you claim California residency? So do you consider California your home state? You can answer yes or no, but please be aware that to be considered for the application fee waiver, which will allow you to submit your application to four Cal State campuses for free, you must be a California resident. To be considered a California resident, you need to live in California for more than 1 year. If you would like more information on the fee waiver, you can go back to www.calstate.edu and click on the search engine. From there, you can select fee waiver and go to search. The first option that comes up is fee waiver. If you click on this link, it will provide you with more information about eligibility criteria for fee waivers and mistakes to avoid. The next question will ask, have you lived in California continuously since birth? Yes or no? If you answer no to do you claim California residency, it will allow you to save and continue, but I'm going to select yes. If you answer no to the question that asks, have you lived in California continuously since birth? It will then ask, when did your present stay in California begin? As an example, I am just going to select yes and save and continue. The next section is regarding race and ethnicity. Please be aware that these questions are only for statistical data. The next section is other information. If you have a social security number, please select yes and enter in your social security number. If you do not have a social security number, please select no and acknowledge that you do not have a social security number. The next question is regarding statewide student ID. As a transfer applicant, you do not have to enter in an SSID. You can actually enter in the number 0. The next question is regarding language proficiency and is asking, what is your first language? It will also allow you to add another language if applicable. It's also asking about military status and military dependent question regarding whether or not you have a parent in the military. Please go through each one and answer according to your parent. This next section is going to ask you whether or not you are in good academic standing. So, are you in good standing with your last school attended? Yes or no? If you are in good standing, please select yes. If you are not in good standing at the last school attended, please select no. If you have questions about your standing, please check with a counselor. The next section is asking for academic infractions and conduct. So there's three questions here. You want to make sure that you answer each one accordingly. Have you ever been disciplined for academic performance? Have you ever been academically disqualified at a college or university? Have you ever been disciplined for student conduct violations? I answered no to each of these, but if I answered yes to any of them, then I will see a box show up at the bottom and it'll ask me to explain and disclose the institution for each violation. I'm going to select no as an example. The next section is asking about teacher or other education credential information. So this is asking whether or not you want to be a teacher or whether or not you want to apply into a credential program. If not, then you can select not interested in a credential program. If you are, then you can select the second or the third option. The next section is asking whether or not you're interested in checking your eligibility for monthly food assistance to be used towards groceries through the CalFresh program. If you want more information about the CalFresh program, please click on the link and it will take you to this page and it will give you more information about the program. The next question is asking whether or not you're interested in participating in the California Promise Program. Same thing, if you want more information about the California Promise Program, please click on the link for the site and it will take you to this page. Please go through it and answer whether or not you want to be a part of this program. The next question is asking, do I have an RN license or expect to achieve an RN license? If you select yes, it will ask you for your RN license. I'm going to select no, just as an example. And the last question, how did you hear about us? I'm going to click on save and continue. And now I'm in the financial and parental information section, which is the last section in quadrant one. Before I go into this section, please be aware that the way that you answer these questions will determine whether or not you are eligible for an application fee waiver. Before you submit your application, you will be able to check your fee waiver eligibility status. If you are eligible for a fee waiver, you can apply to a maximum of 4 CSU campuses for free. If you are not eligible for the fee waiver, you will be charged $70 per CSU campus receiving your application. Please note that the way that you answer these questions does not affect your financial aid eligibility. Also, keep in mind that once you submit your application, you cannot edit this section. The first part of this section is regarding household income and size information. Please review the following statements listed in the bullets, then apply them to the question below. Please read each bullet carefully. Let's review the first two statements as an example. The first one, you were born before January 1st, 1997. The second one, are you currently an active duty member or a veteran of the U.S. Armed Forces? Again, read each statement carefully. Once you are done, answer the question below. Do any of the above statements apply to you? If you click on none of the above statements apply to me, you are identified as a dependent and the household size and income questions will expand below, but they will be specifically for dependent applicants. If you select one or more of the above statements apply to me, you are identifying as independent, and the questions will expand, but they will be specifically for independent students. Let's take a look at the household size and income information questions if I were answering as a dependent. The first question is asking for the total size of parents' or step-parents' household. And in this example, the application is asking for the household size in 2019. Remember that this question and the income questions below are regarding only your parents or step-parents if you are dependent. Now let's see how these questions change when I identify as independent. The first question is asking for the total size of your household in 2019. Remember to include yourself. It will then ask for the number of dependent children living with you in 2019. If your answer is zero, please report zero. Do not leave any fields blank. Also remember when answering questions about the adjusted gross income, also known as the AGI, and untaxed income, not to report duplicate amounts like I did here. These numbers should not be the same. If you have any questions about how to answer household size or income information, please click on the link below the household size heading and it will bring you to this page. This page separates independent students and dependent students when assisting with details of how to answer each specific question. The next question is regarding campus housing. Are you interested in on-campus housing should space be available? You can answer yes or no. And the last question is regarding parent or guardian education level. It will ask you for parent or guardian number one and parent or guardian number two. Here it's asking for their highest level of education. Please be sure to go through each one and answer accordingly. And when you're finished, click on save and continue. After clicking on save and continue, it will then ask you if you want to go back to the dashboard or continue to the next section. I selected go back to dashboard and now I'm in the dashboard. Now that I'm in the dashboard, I can see that I've already completed all of quadrant one because the whole circle is filled green and it says sections completed. Please view our next video on how to answer quadrant number two. Thank you for watching.